بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم welcome in our discussion related to performance management and reward systems in context. This is the opening chapter from the book of Herman. The title of the book is Performance Management. The overview of chapter is talking about definition of performance management. Then we'll be talking about the performance management contribution. Afterwards, disadvantages, dangers of poorly implemented performance management systems, definition of reward systems, that would be discussed, purposes of performance management system, characteristics of an ideal performance management system, integration with other human resource and development activities, and performance management around the world. These are the major contents we'll be talking about. In these contents, particularly when you talk about reward and compensation system, we discussed about that earlier in our sessions as well. So there will be a little introduction and orientation about the subject in this book as well. Now, first of all, let's start with the definition of performance management. Basically, performance management is in relation with organizational working, and we are involved in technically calculating how much people are coming up with their effort and what amount of performance in terms of the achievement of their KRA, KPA, and KPIs is actually being witnessed. So remember one thing, that performance management is a continuous process of identifying, measuring, and developing the performance of individuals and teams. So we have got three important steps in this continuous process. First of all, we have to identify that which parameters are to be evaluated. And those parameters are obviously discussed in your job description document in terms of your TDRs, task duties and responsibilities, and in terms of key result areas, key performance areas, and key performance indicators. So we have to identify all the key aspects in which we need to get the performance. Once the parameters of performance are identified, the next step would be that we have to measure them. And obviously, you cannot measure anything unless and until you don't quantify them. So all of the parameters of performance must be quantified. And then obviously, then you are going to measure those outcomes in terms of the standards or in terms of their past experience or past performance, or you are going to measure their performance in terms of any benchmark value. So it all depends that what aspects you have put, what merit you have established with which you have to compare their performance to check either they are doing above average or they're doing below average or they are around the average. So once the performance is identified, once the performance is measured, the next step would be developing. And the developing would mean that as the organization would be developing its objectives and targets, as our organization would be trying to come up with more productivity, profitability, and satisfaction of the stakeholders. So we have to see that on the basis of the current performance results, what can be the future targets and objectives, which are eventually going to be translated into the KPIs of jobs in different departments. So the whole performance phenomena can be measured, can be assigned in terms of individuals, or it can be assigned in terms of teams as well. The second aspect that what performance management is talking about aligning performance with the strategic goals of the organization. As you all know, that organizations are going to set three types of goals: strategic, financial, and operational. So the most important are the strategic ones, because the strategic ones are basically targeting the long-term development and growth of the organization. So we have to see that how those strategic performance targets and objectives related to the whole organization are linked with the HR element, how human resource is going to contribute towards the development and towards the achievement of those particular objectives. So that is the reason it is written on the slide that we have to align performance with the strategic goals of the organization in terms of obviously long-term perspectives and definitely towards the direction of mission and vision. Now, if we further continue the discussion related to the performance management, it is argued that performance management is not performance appraisal. Remember, these two are different expressions. Technically speaking, when we use the word performance appraisal, we are referring to a periodic check. And most of the organizations, when they used the expression of performance appraisal, they followed the scheme of 1 year assessment. Okay, after 1 year, they would be evaluating and calculating the performance of the employees and checking it that where do they need improvement and what are the better aspects. And accordingly, they'll be giving the compensation and benefits on the yearly basis. Okay, but the problem associated with the performance appraisal was that once you check the performance after a year, the whole year has gone. Okay, you cannot bring the time back. So when you cannot bring the time back, so obviously in that case, it would be difficult for you to correct the problems which happened during the year. Okay, to manage all this discrepancy, performance management system was actually introduced. And the performance management system is basically is a continuous process. It's not a periodic measure. It's a continuous process which basically is associated with the organization 24/7 and 365. Okay, so around the clock, the performance management system is operational in the organizations, and the continuous performance is assessed, and continuous feedback and continuous corrections are to be taken. Okay, so that's how the performance management is actually different from the periodic measure, which was performance appraisal. Now, if we further try to create a difference between performance management and performance appraisal, it is said that the performance management is basically linked with strategic business considerations, okay, which are technically speaking, long-term considerations. Whereas performance appraisal is basically linked with the HR activities. Secondly, when you talk about performance management, it is driven by line manager. That every line manager would be looking after the details under his supervision. Whereas when you talk about performance appraisal, so that is basically linked with assesses employee strengths and weaknesses. Mostly the context was to find out after a year that what are the strengths, what are the weaknesses associated with the employee. The third difference which we can create in terms of performance management, it is an ongoing feedback, as I use the expression of 24/7, 365. So employees can improve performance as and whenever there is any performance deficiency. But when we talk about performance appraisal, as I told you, it is usually done once a year, and basically it lacks ongoing feedback. Okay, so the problems which may occur in the start of the year, they may be addressed at the end of the year. Okay, so that is basically the problem was with performance appraisal environment. Okay, so most of the organizations these days are moving towards the performance management systems rather than just focusing upon yearly assessments. Now, once we look at the contributions of performance management, we can think in terms of three aspects: performance management for employees, performance management for managers, and performance management for organization and HR function as whole. Okay, so in the next coming slides, we'll be talking about these three aspects of performance management related to the employees, managers, and organizations as a whole. When we talk about performance management in terms of employees, the most important concern we have is that it requires a clear definition of the job. That is the reason that we emphasized a lot on job description. We emphasized a lot on defining your TDRs and KSCOs. We emphasized a lot on developing your job description in terms of key result areas, key performance areas, and key performance indicators. Okay, remember that whatever functionality you are going to talk about related to the HR, you just cannot avoid these terms. So that is the reason that I always emphasize a lot in developing of these expressions. So when we talk about performance management, the first thing we have seen that it clearly defines or clearly requires the definition of the job. And obviously, related to the job, what is the success criteria? What is the merit that you have established to evaluate the performance of the people? What are the targets? What are the associated results you need to achieve? So you should be very much clear that what actually a job entails and what actually are going to be the outcomes related to the jobs of individuals, then as groups, then as departments, and then as whole organization. The second contribution which we are getting from the performance management of employees is basically increase motivation to perform. As the people would be given continuous feedback, as they would be knowing that whatever they are doing, either it is related to the merit or not, either they are doing, either they are actually working as high performance workers or employees, or they are working as low performance worker or employees. So as the performance levels would be continuously shared with them, so they would be able to make the corrective actions. Okay. So that is the reason the point is written over here is increase motivation to perform. And obviously, when we are providing the continuous feedback, we'll be there to provide them right rewards and right compensations accordingly as well. Another contribution, which is coming from the performance management for employees, is basically focused upon increased self-esteem. And how self-esteem would be increased? Because people would be aware that how much they are performing, how much they should be performing, and what are the deficiency areas. And from the identification of the deficiency areas, we'll be better able to identify the training need assessments. And from the training need assessments, we'll be there to develop the training and development programs so that people are given the best opportunity and chance to develop their working. And obviously, that would increase and boost the employees' morale and their self-esteem. Another expression, which is the contribution of performance management for employees, is talking about enhanced self-insight and development. As I told you earlier, that you will be able to identify the deficiency areas. And once those deficiency areas are identified, then obviously employees would be able to assess their current performance. They can plan for their future performance and they can make corrective actions for any past discrepancies. When we talk about performance management for managers, there are four aspects your book is talking about. The first aspect is that the performance management program would enable the managers to communicate supervisors' views of performance more clearly. Okay? Because the performance requirements, performance merit, performance deficiencies, they would be disclosed, they would be open, and everybody would be able to visualize that how much is required and how much they are putting in. So a proper communication can be established in between the supervisors and their respective subordinates. The second contribution, which is coming from the establishment of proper performance management systems, that is basically that managers gain insight about subordinates. They know which subordinate is weak in which aspects related to the job, related to the task and duties assigned, and how those deficiencies can be improved, and who is the person who is categorized as high performer, and the person who is doing the high performance is able to come up with high performance. What are the attributes? What are the competencies? What are the skills associated with that phenomena? The third contribution coming from the performance management for managers is talking about better and more timely differentiation between good and poor performers. Okay, so you'll be able to evaluate the performance, and obviously on that calculation, you'll be able to identify and categorize the people as high performers and poor performers. The fourth aspect, that employees become more competent, because during the work, their deficiencies in competencies and their expertise related to their proficiencies, they are all identified on the spot. And once the things are identified, once the things are measured, so it would be easy for us to develop them. When we talk about contribution of performance management for organization and HR function, following are the aspects given in your book. The first most aspect is talking about clarify organizational goals. Because we are going to talk about in quantity, we're going to talk about in smart fashion. So there would be a clarity of what organization is actually targeting. Because unless and until an organization would not be identifying and quantifying their targets and objectives, the cascading of objectives would not be possible. Okay, so to translate the requirements of individual jobs, first aspect is that organizations should be clear in what they want to achieve. The second thing is facilitate organizational change, because organization would be very clear and quantified in their determination of performance. And once the clarity is there, so they would be able to judge that what change in particular they need to adopt for the future. And how can, obviously, they can break the status quo. The third aspect is fairer and more appropriate administrative actions can be taken. Okay, so when we talk about appropriate administrative actions, so you cannot take any action if the merit is not established. And the fourth most important contribution coming from the performance management systems is talking about better protection from lawsuits, that there should not be any discrimination based upon any compensation and benefits. There should not be any discrimination based upon the hiring of the people. There should not be any discrimination based upon the performance appraisal. There should not be any discrimination based upon any of the rights and privileges given to the employees. So this system is basically focusing upon improving the compliance of the organization as a whole, as a total, so that the organization is never subjected to any lawsuits. At the same time, we need to focus upon that what can be the disadvantages or dangers of poorly implemented performance management systems. So we are again going to translate our disadvantages in terms of employees and managers and organization and HR function. First of all, let's look at the disadvantages and dangers of poorly implemented performance management systems for employees. As the benefit was that it can improve the self-esteem, obviously the disadvantage can be that if it is poorly defined system, it can lower the self-esteem of the people. That environment of mistrust and distrust would be created, and people would not be willing to engage and involve in the organizational perspectives with their whole heart. The second disadvantage can be if there is poorly defined performance management system is related with the employee burnout and job dissatisfaction. So obviously job stress would be created, and it would not be an environment in which people would be willing to contribute effectively and efficiently. This whole phenomena is going to damage the relationships. And lastly, it is said that use of false and misleading information would obviously contaminate the results, would contaminate the information, and resultantly, organization is going to suffer. When we talk about disadvantages and dangers of poorly implemented performance management systems for managers, the first most dangerous aspect would be increased turnover. Because as I told you earlier, that if the trust is not established between the employee and the employer, so obviously they would be willing to leave. Secondly, decreased motivation to perform, because they would not be engaged, they would not be involved, they would not be motivated. Unjustified demands on managers' resources, that is another big problem we need to focus. And another factor would be varying and unfair standards and ratings. So these are all the issues associated with the poorly defined or implemented performance management system. So we need to be very much careful that how and why these systems are to be established, and how can we make things happen in a way that can result in organizational long-term development. Our first Zoom session is ending. Please join in the second Zoom session at 1:15. Thank you.